What's going on, guys? I got another little quickie shop project here. We're going to be building a very simple hydraulic press. Now, basically what started me on this project is, well, I've got a project coming up over here in the C10 where I'm going to need a hydraulic press. And I've got a whole cache of short pieces, cut off material around the corner in a couple of trash cans. And I'm trying to reduce the quantity of the material that I have kicking around. And so I wanted to use it for something useful. So that's what we're doing here. And we're just going to be using this very simple little 4-ton bottle jack. Now the frame material, we've got, let's see, this was, okay, it's 2.5-inch square tubing. And if I remember, square tubing has a wall thickness of 3/16. And this round tubing, 1.5-inch round tubing with an 1/8-inch wall. Okay, so, and then this piece, the square tubing, is 28 5/8 inch long. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut this in half. We're gonna make two pieces that are 14 5/16 inches long. One will be the bottom. This chunk over here that we're gonna cut off, that'll be the top. These two pieces of round tubing, they're almost the same length. I measured them out. One was 12 3/4. And the other's, 12 7/8 and 12 3/4. So we're gonna cut the long one down to match the short one. These will be our uprights. And I'm kind of building this as a general hydraulic press, but specifically the project that I've got coming up on the C10, I'm gonna be using some dimple dies. Now this is the only one I have. It's a 1/2-inch diameter dimple die. You can see the little kind of fillet there on this piece. So you drill your hole, you put your material through there. This has a corresponding little bevel inside there. Put it in, press them together. And that's how you get your dimple die or your speed hole, whatever you want to call them. This is actually the only one that I have. And I think I've had this for at least 10 years. It may be 12 years now, but it's the only one I have, and I think I'm probably going to buy some more. I don't remember this being that expensive. I mean, just looking at it, that's not an expensive tool. At least it shouldn't be. So I may order up a few more of these if I can find the same, the dimple dies in the same style as this. So that's the project. It's a very simple cut and weld project. We're going to TIG weld all this because I still have the TIG welder set up there in the garage. And so let's just go ahead and get started on it. We'll get the bandsaw up here on the workbench and start making some cuts, getting everything cut to length, cut as square as we can get it. And then we'll take it inside and start welding on it. So, I've got this pretty well jigged up. I've got a little stop right here to keep my round tube from rolling over too far. Let me just double check that I'm still square. So that's showing square. That's showing square. Of course, double check that with cross measure. 22 3/4. Yeah, 22 3/4, a little bit less. That's close enough for me. So I need to put a little clamp. Let's see. Somewhere on here. I'll hold this in place. We'll get a couple tacks on here. What you can't see in the video, well, you can kind of see a little bit of it. There's a half inch piece of wood holding up. Let's see if I can lift this out of the way. There's a little half inch piece of wood that's kind of supporting this to sort of center it up in between in the center of the square tubing. So let me get this clamped down and we'll fire up the welder and we'll lay a few tack welds in there, flip it over, tack weld the other side, and then we'll be ready to lay some beads. So one little thing I should note here, when I clamped this down, I rolled this piece of tubing in towards the center just a little bit so that I got about an eighth of an inch between the side of the tube and the side of the round tube and the edge of the square tube. So there's just a little bit of a lip there. Both sides clamped down in place. So put a couple of tack welds on there. That's it, all the welding is finished. So it's a real simple structure. Just a couple pieces of square tube, couple pieces of round tube. Now some of the welds are a little bit better than the others, but that's always the case. So we'll take it outside, put it out on the workbench, drill some holes in some material, and test out that dimple die. All right, well, we're completely finished with it, and we just did a little bit of testing. Used that dimple die to put some holes in some material. This is 80 thousandths thick aluminum. And this was a piece of 14 gauge steel, just little scraps that I had kicking around. I wish I could tell you more about this little dimple die and where I got it, but like I said, that was 10 or 12 years ago, so I honestly don't remember. We could certainly use this thing. That's my intended purpose in the very near future, is that little project I gotta do on the truck over there. Put some dimple dies in that, but we could use this thing for all sorts of stuff. I've got plans kind of in my head for maybe getting some thick quarter inch angle iron and making some kind of like a press break, or even breaking out the grinder and making some louvers, making a louver punch for this thing. So, you know, one thing I haven't checked, I actually haven't checked my inside measurements. Let me do that real quick. All right, in between the round tubing, I got just over 11 inches. I haven't checked this one. 4 5/8 from the base of this. And this is kind of neat, this little threaded part in the jack. Makes for a quick adjustment. But 4 5/8 of throat depth here. So, but that 11 inches, that would have come in real handy for that coolant reservoir that I just finished making not too long ago. Because the length of that was 10 1/2 inches, so that would have fit perfectly in there if I'd had this and made a press brake sort of attachment. So that's it. I appreciate you guys watching. I had a lot of new subscribers the past couple weeks. My phone's just been blowing up my email. So my phone's been going off with, I mean, God, 10 or 12 new subscribers every day. So I appreciate that. I want to thank all those new subscribers and all my existing subscribers. So that's it for this video. Check out my Facebook page. I post all the pictures, everything that I've been working on, whether it's the C10, whether it's my buddy's old shovelhead chopper project, stuff I'm working on over at my brother's house on his Tacoma. All the pictures, anything that I do that I post to YouTube, those pictures and the videos go to my Facebook page. So go ahead and check that out. Give me a like, subscribe, comment. I try and reply to all comments as soon as I can. So once again, thanks guys.